comfort him. They could not even recognize him from a distance. Adding to Job's pain, his friends falsely accused him of wrongdoings and blamed his troubles on his unrepentant heart. Through it all, Job patiently endured. Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was a Baptist minister, a civil rights leader, and a source of hope to millions of people. Whether it was leading the Montgomery boycott started by Sister Rosa Parks in 1955, or protesting in Birmingham, or marching to Washington to deliver his famous I Have a Dream speech. Dr. King was a courageous leader who inspired millions of people and changed the course of history. Today, nearly 50 years from his death, as we remember Dr. Martin Luther King, we can also be inspired by his patience. One of the most admirable qualities that Dr. Martin Luther King demonstrated was his ability to be patient. He had to wait many years and overcome many obstacles to make progress towards his goals. The art of patience today is hard to find in our high-paced world. Many cry out to God and say, God, give me patience, but I want it right now. We live in a world of instant gratification. If you want to purchase something, if you can't wait to buy it in the store, you can go online and have it delivered to your home tomorrow. If you want to get in contact with someone, you don't just call them anymore. You can text them, Facebook message them, email them, tweet them, Snapchat them, and the list goes on and on. Having access to whatever we want, whenever we want, has changed our lives. People have become less patient in their daily lives that they live in because of cell phones and internet. We eat fast food and expect a faster diet plan. We are in a society of moving a mile a minute, and we think that it's good for us. There's even a church in Florida that advertises a 22-minute service. You'll be in and out in 22 minutes. Before our time, people could find everything they needed. They couldn't find everything they needed in a grocery store. They had to go different places to find what they need, and they had to wait on snail mail. I think that this taught our parents and grandparents how to be patient and how to appreciate and enjoy the journey. Their generation have the foresight to see the bigger picture instead of what is right in front of them. Our generation can sometimes become lost in technology so much that we don't think about the life's bigger plans. We only see what's right in front of us. Our generation needs to learn to understand, to be more successful in life, we have to be patient to be more successful in life. We need to understand that just because we don't have the perfect job right now, live in a nice house right now, or have the perfect spouse right now, that doesn't mean that those things won't come into our life eventually. Have patience, but just don't wait on it. There's a proverb that goes, all good things come to those that wait. Well, this is a well-known saying, and it has a lot of truth in it, but I've come to learn that it's also flawed. Good things do not come to those who just wait. Good things come to those who wait, but actively do things while they're waiting. If waiting was all it took to have good things in life and to achieve all your dreams, then that's effortlessly. Have patience, but don't just look to others. Do not judge your success based on other people's success. One thing that makes people impatient is to see that other people are getting ahead of them faster. At such times, it's easy to leave your plan and to seek a shortcut to success. But this should not be the case. In order to have patience, it is necessary that you know your plan and that you live by your plan. Now today, I'm not just speaking to you about success. Today, I'm speaking to you about success, but that does not mean that I'll always be patient because I'm only human. What it does mean is that I will be more aware of how to handle my impatience in the future. And I ask that each and every one of you today take a challenge, and the next time you find yourself losing patience, remember to think of Dr. Martin Luther King's patience, remember to think of Job's patience, and to remember to think about what I spoke to you today about patience and how you can improve your life by thinking positively. Thank you.
Tisdale, please join me at the pulpit. three grandchildren, and they have one on the way. She received Jesus as her Lord and Savior in the year of 1989. Miss Pam McKenzie Tisdale.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
It is such an honor to be with you this morning, and thank you, Miss Paisley, for allowing me to be with you all this morning. Such an honor to be here. Such a great topic of integrity. Such a great man to honor this morning is Dr. King as we talk about integrity. He definitely showed us integrity in the way he handled things. Integrity is who you are when no one else is looking. When you're by yourself and behind closed doors, are you going to do the right thing? Let me ask you, and this really hit home as I began to put my thoughts together this morning and began to think about what integrity really is. Do I put the shopping cart away when I go to Walmart, or do I leave it in the middle of the aisle? If I discovered that the lady at the counter didn't give me, she gave me back too much change, do I walk back in the store and return it? And this has happened to me before. I get to my car and I start unloading my things from the grocery store, and I realize that the lady at the counter who was checking me out did not see my bottle of my case of water down under my cart. Do I walk back in there and pay for it? These things show our integrity. No one would ever know I didn't pay for that case of water, but me and the Lord. Integrity is living life above the normal, living life in excellence. We look at Daniel in chapter 6, verse 3, and this is what is said of Daniel. Then this Daniel was preferred above the presidents and the princes, because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king thought to set him over the whole realm. Daniel was a man of excellence. He did things above the average, and it brought promotion to his life. The spirit of excellence that he carried brought promotion to him. Your integrity, your word, keeping your promises, your agreements, being honest, leads us all to success. The word tells us we must strive to be like Jesus. He was without fault. Living a life of integrity is a start to our testament to our Lord Jesus Christ. Let's look at the life of Dr. King this morning. He was a man of integrity. He faced great opposition. Great opposition, but yet he always kept his character. Even behind closed doors, I would like to know that he kept his character. So as we think about success in life, this should be the very beginning of our striving to be successful in life, is to keeping our character, our integrity, and doing things right when they're not popular, even when it's going against the grain. Keeping our integrity.